All right, so for our next speaker, Dr. Gireeja Ranade is a researcher at Microsoft Research AI and is a currently visiting fellow right over here at the Simons Institute for Theoretical Computer Science. She also received her MS and PhD from EECS at UC Berkeley.
Thank you. It's really an honor to be here. Very humbling to be speaking in front of this audience today. So thank you very much to the organizers. I know how much hard work you've been putting in for this. So today I thought I'm going to talk about a project that's a little bit different from the work that I usually do, but is something that has been very eye-opening for me in understanding how much there is at the intersection of people and technology that I really don't understand, and as a computer scientist and engineer, how there are many, many questions that I need to be thinking about going forward. So this is a project that I started with some colleagues at Microsoft Research right after the presidential election in November 2016. And we were discussing the outcome of the election, and we started seeing a lot of media popping up about, oh, there was fake news in the election that impacted the election, and fake news had very strong influences. And being at Microsoft, especially, one of the things we wanted to do was understand, well, you know, did it really have an impact? And what do we even mean by fake news? This is a term that keeps being thrown around in the media, but we don't fully understand what it means. And if it did have an impact, how did it have an impact? How did it spread? And so I'm going to share some preliminary interesting things that we found out in the process of this investigation. So fake news is something that is really not new. It's been around since, you know, even before the internet, since the existence of print media. For example, there, you know, false news is something that has been mentioned way back in 1866. And of course, today we hear this in the news quite a bit. So in that context, I wanted to ask, how many people in this room have heard of ABC News? And how many people have seen this website, abcnews.com.co? And how many people have maybe visited this other website, which is another ABC News? So now, if I was to tell you something interesting about these two websites, that for the URL abcnews.com.co, over 90% of the incoming traffic comes from social media, whereas for this website abcnews.go.com, only about 20% of the incoming traffic is from social media. Does this change how you're starting to perceive either of these websites? Turns out that abcnews.com.co is a well-known fake news website. This is a list of the Wikipedia list of fake news websites that has been evolving very, very rapidly in the past year, has come to some sort of a steady state at this point. But this is well known as a website that tries to impersonate a real news website and feeds information that is quite fake. For example, here there's a story talking about Obama banning the Pledge of Allegiance in schools nationwide. So looking at these kind of websites, what we decided to do was we wanted to try and understand how people arrived at some of these websites. And what we're really interested in understanding, this is ongoing work, is what do they do once they actually end up at a website that may or may not be providing them truthful information. So what we looked at was we looked at data from the Internet Explorer and Edge browser logs, which is a and we looked at data from the beginning of the national conventions all the way up until the election in 2016. And what we did was we wanted to understand how people arrived at fake news websites, but after a lot of trying, we could not figure out what it meant for a website or a story to involve fake news. And so we decided to entirely sidestep the question. And we relied on lists that were curated by Wikipedia, Snopes, as well as BuzzFeed to try and define what it is to be fake news. And this is a question that I think it's a really important question to think about that I'm happy to talk more about later. So within our data set, we looked at basically what this graph is showing is the x-axis is a bunch of domains that we saw that are already looked at. And the y-axis is showing the fraction of traffic that is coming from social media. And as you can see, a large fraction of the traffic is coming from social media. And this is something that is making many technology companies, including Microsoft, really concerned about the issue and wants to do something about it. But surprisingly, what we saw is that there are other websites that are known to also provide stories that are not true that had very small amounts of incoming traffic from social media. So Infowars.com is one of such example. And for those of you who have heard of the Pizzagate scandal, Infowars was one of the websites that really popularized this story. This is the story about a pizza parlor being a front for a pedophile ring that might be run by Hillary Clinton. And for this website, actually only 7% of the inbound traffic came from social media. So what we decided to do is we wanted to try and understand what is the landscape of these stories. And if you look at, for example, another story from Infowars, what this is showing is a histogram of the story of traffic to this particular story. And you can see that this story is kind of a one-hit wonder. Most of the people visited this story on one day, and most of the hits did not come from social media. In contrast, if you were to look at the ABC News story that I showed you earlier, here there's kind of a very much wider spread of when people actually read the story. Furthermore, there's a very large fraction of people who came to the story via social media. And this was quite a surprise to us, the fact that there's many different types of agencies that are trying to provide and create fictitious stories. I can give you a couple more examples, but in the interest of time, I'm not really going to go into too many details on this. Something that I found that was particularly interesting is these scatter plots, which are actually classifying different types of fake news domains. So what's being shown up here is Infowars.com. The x-axis is the fraction of referrals from social media, whereas the y-axis is kind of the maximum visitation rate, how many people showed up on one day. And Infowars.com is a well-known conspiracy theory website that gets a lot of dedicated followers. And you can see that this kind of has a qualitatively different feel than, for example, the histogram for endingthefed.com, which was discovered to be a website that was run by teenagers out of Macedonia. And it was really a website that was purely being run to generate ad revenue. The people who were running the website didn't care about the outcome of the election, in as much as they cared about, you know, having more pocket money to spend. So there's a bunch of interesting patterns that turns out exist in this data. And I think that what this means is that when we're thinking about, this problem of fake news, this one phrase is much more loaded and has a lot more nuance than having a one-shot solution. And I think that there's a bunch of interesting questions that we as people who work in technology can help address in collaboration with people who have a better understanding of politics as well as the social sciences. And in conclusion, I wanted to just try and say something about this question that we asked about, well, does fake news really matter? Did it have an impact on the election? And this is something that I would love to answer, but I can't. In our data set, there was a shockingly low fraction of people that actually were exposed to a fake news article. So only 0.3% of all of our users saw this. But if you compare this to the click-through rates on advertisements, this is actually quite comparable in terms of order of magnitude. And we're just comparing click-through rates. So people might have actually seen this in their news feeds or just as links much more. The last graph shows something that's kind of interesting, where what we're seeing is on the x-axis the fraction of vote won by Donald Trump, and the y-axis is the fraction of our users that visited a fake news domain. And what you see is a very clean correlation. And this was something that was really surprising to us at first, and in retrospect is something that is entirely obvious. And what you can see is that even though there's been a lot of media that has been trying to send us to understand the impact of fake news in one way versus another, a very simple model that thinks about homophily in social networks can actually easily explain such a correlation. And with that, I guess I'll conclude by saying that this is something that where there's a lot more questions than there are answers, and I'd be happy to talk more to people. Thanks.